शंकराय च मयस्कराय च नमः शिवाय च शिवतराय च त्र्यम्बकं यजामहे सुगन्धिं पुष्टिवकरं नवरुदारुकमिव गन्धराजितो मुखीयमामृता।
Okay. Hello friends, this is KK Singh, Vedic Astrologer, and welcome to my YouTube channel Om Astro Jyoti. So today we are having a wonderful guest with us, and she is Monisha Bhatia ji. Welcome ma'am to the channel, and today she is going to give us a lesson on Navamsha. Now the Navamsha series will be like, in this video she is going to give us like how the Navamsha means, what is the Navamsha actually and why it is so important, and she will definitely give us an example chart also and make us understand how to read the Navamsha. Okay Monisha ji, without wasting any time, so I would ask you to take the stage, and just before taking up the stage, before giving anything on Navamsha, just give us a brief introduction regarding yourself, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you Kaushal ji for inviting me to your channel, and I would just like to introduce myself that I am basically a person who has been doing astrology since I was at the age of 15, and ever since then the interest started developing further, and around 14 years back, I learned it professionally from Shri Manoj Bhandari sir, and after that, I learned advanced astrology from Shri Abhimantrit sir, and then I got interested in learning Nari astrology also, which I did from Shri Satya Narayan Nayak sir, and I did Nari astrology techniques from Shri A.V. Sundaram sir also, and I did my research Vedic astrology classes from Shri V.P. Goel sir. And simultaneously, I am learning KP also and Gemini also. See, astrology is such a vast ocean that the more you enter into it, the more shells you will discover. It is a never-ending study.
100%. As you have said that it is a very vast ocean, and it is like infinite. The more you get in, the more you will think that, no, I don't know anything. You have to dive deep into it more. So definitely that is one thing. So Monisha ji, I just wanted to ask you, like we have, like when I was studying in under Pandit Ramana Tripathi ji, so he used to say that Navamsha is the soul of the charts. Okay, so what, how can you means explain this? Because the thing is, when Navamsha we are looking at, many a times there is independent calculation of independent interpretation, of the Navamsha. That is another topic. But why the Navamsha is so very important? Just give us the insight there.
See, Navamsha chart is basically a very important part. First of all, we'll start with the mathematical part. It is like in Shadbala, we give 5 points to calculate. So points to the Navamsha chart. Sorry. 6 points to the main chart, Rashi chart, and 5 points to the Navamsha chart. From this only you can understand how important it is. Now it is called as the soul of the horoscope. Reason being that whatever promises are there in your main chart, that is the Rashi chart, whether they are going to materialize or not, that can only be ascertained by the use of the Navamsha chart. Unless you see the Navamsha, you cannot conclude the things rightly. Because many a times we will see that there are Raj Yogas being promised in the Rashi chart, but they do not materialize. The answer lies in the Navamsha chart. If a planet is getting debilitated in the Navamsha chart, or if it has gone to its enemy sign in the Navamsha, or if it has gone to the 6th house, 8th house, or 12th house in the Navamsha chart, in that case, even if it is a Raj Yogi planet, it will fail to deliver. It will not give results, and the person will eventually suffer during that planet's dasha. So, see, Navamsha chart is basically the 9th division of your Rashi chart. Your Rashi chart is composed of 30. There are 12 signs, and each sign is 30 degrees. If we want to know the deeper understanding of each sign, we have to divide it by 9. So 30 degrees divided by 9 will give us 3.2 degrees. So in the Navamsha chart, each sign is of 3.2 degrees, and that will give you the minute details of your D1 chart. They will explain the things in detail. This is how also you can use the Navamsha chart. Secondly, tell you about the strength of the planets of the Rashi chart, how they are placed in the Navamsha. Suppose a planet is looking exalted in the Rashi chart, but in the Navamsha, it has gone to its enemy sign or it has become debilitated. In that case, the results are not going to be good. Eventually, the things look good, but in the beginning, the things look good, but eventually they will give you sufferings. Now, if a planet is Vargotami, it means in the Rashi chart, it is in the same sign, and in the D9 chart also, it is going to the same sign. In that case, it is going to give you excellent results because it becomes Vargotami. It will give you name, fame, wealth during its dasha. If the planet goes towards enemy sign in the Navamsha, in that case, even if it is looking good in the D, will not give you good results. It will give you sufferings. Now, there is also a controversy about the Degotama. Sometimes the planet is debilitated in the main chart, and in the Rashi, in the Navamsha chart also, it becomes debilitated. In that case, some people say that the results are very bad. But in my understanding, in my practice, I have seen that a debilitated planet will give you good things like name, fame, but it will results related to your health. If it is debilitated Vargotami, it will give you riches. That is, there is no doubt about that because it is Vargotami, but it will give you difficulties related to your health part. Personal level sufferings would be there, but money point of view or career point of view, it is not considered bad if it is debilitated in the Navamsha chart. So that is why it becomes a very important chart for understanding. Another thing is that if we talk about the signs, there are three categories which we have made for each Amsha. That is, if a planet from whatever sign it is placed in your D1 chart, it goes to 1, 4, 7, 10. These are the air signs. These are the movable signs. So if a planet goes to a movable sign, it means it has gone to the Adrid Navamsha. Which means during that planet's dasha, if you do little bit of efforts, the things will change. Or sometimes without efforts also, things will change. So these are good Navamshas for a planet to be in. 1, 4, 7, 10. These are the good Navamshas. These are called as the Adrid Navamshas. Similarly, if a planet goes to fixed signs, that is 2, 5, 8 and 11, in these Navamshas, if a planet is going in the D9 chart, this shows as the Drid Navamsha. So it means that despite your efforts to improve the conditions of that planet, the results will not be felt because certain things have been done in the past life which cannot be changed.
Right.
So person is bound to suffer during those planet specials which have gone to the fixed signs. But again, there is an addition to it. If a planet goes to a benefic sign in the Navamsha chart, like sign of Taurus and sign of Taurus is a benefic sign. If a planet goes to Taurus, although there would be some kind of difficulties or comfort would be felt, but overall, because Taurus is a benefic Amsha, the planet will give you monetary wise, it will give you good results. This thing also has to be kept in mind. Now, the third category is Drid Adrid, which is 3, 6, 9, and 12. So, if a planet goes to these Amshas, 12. So, if a planet goes to these Amshas, in that case, it means that sometimes with efforts, the results can be felt, the results can be changed, but sometimes they will not change. So, that depends upon the conditions. So, these are the three categories which can be listed. And anything else you want to ask?
No, no. Means you have explained this very beautifully, because I was about to ask about the Vargottami, Neech Vargottami, especially the planet is getting debilitated in both D1 and D9. So you have, before asking only, you have gave the answer, and that was wonderful interpretation. So if then we definitely move on to the next part, like how we should be reading it. So for that, I guess you have some material. So yes, yeah. You can share the screen for that.
Kaushal ji, before moving to the screen, I will also like to add that Navamsha chart can tell you a lot of things, which I was hoping that you will be asking, so I'll tell you. So these can be read as independent chart, like D1 chart, they can be read as independent chart after you turn 30.
Right.
But they are all from your day one of your birth, the Navamsha chart is always active, because I told you these are the soul of the main chart. But if you have to read an independent chart, Navamsha chart can be read as the independent chart, but after only you turn 30 or after you...
Yes, yes. Because there is a dispute in this statement, because if a person is getting married at 24, his Navamsha gets active. That, yes. That I have been practicing for many days. That earlier of the both, like either 30 or the getting married.
So you can, whatever, see, the results are being felt in the D1 can independently be assessed from the D9 chart also in that case. So this is another use of the D9 chart. Then if you go by the books of Shri C.S. Patel, sir, he has taught that the Navamsha charts can be used for interpreting the results of the transit of planets. Yes.
In Rashi Tulya Navamsha, I guess Rashi Tulya Navamsha and Navamsha Tulya Rashi, in this famous book, he have given that method.
Yeah, Rashi Tulya Navamsha is also very important aspect of astrology, where the Navamshas are used. I will be using that in my examples.
Right.
But at the same time, if we have to study the transit results, then also Navamsha charts are very, very important, that we can make a separate video for that.
Yes, 100%. No issue.
Then to understand the spirituality of a person, how spiritual this person is going to be, we have to go to the Navamsha chart, especially the 159 signs or 159 houses. If many of your planets have gone to 159 house in the D9 chart, the person will turn very spiritual, even if it is not showing in the D1 chart. Or if they have gone to 159 signs in the D9 chart, then also the person will be very, very spiritual. So this is another use of the Navamsha chart. So there can be many other uses of Navamsha. So okay. Now should I share the screen?
Yes, yes. You can share the screen. Thank you. One second.
Here I have this example of Shri Amitabh Bachchan ji, in which I will explain to you the use of the Navamsha chart.
Ji.
So basically, in the year 1980, August, he was a star, as you all know, but for the foreign viewers, I'm just telling. So he's a superstar in India. And on 2nd August 1982, he was undergoing some shooting for his film Kooli. At that time, he was very badly hit on his abdomen. And he was literally on coma during that time. And people were praying for his safety. It was a very, very severe condition for Mr. Amitabh Bachchan. So let's see how Navamsha will give us the true picture of the outcome for this situation. So at that time, on 2nd August 1982, the Dasha was of Saturn, Sun and Ketu. So first of all, in the main chart, Saturn is the ascending lord and also the 12th lord. And it is retrograde and sitting in the Kendra house.
Yes.
So see, there is another rule. If a planet is retrograde, it will also give you the results of the
previous house.
If Saturn is considered in the previous house, it is getting debilitated. But being retrograde will give you the results of exaltation. So what I want to say is that something negative is bound to happen during that time. and it will also show reversal because there is cancellation of debilitation. So the main dasha is showing that the hospitalization or 12th house is also going to get activated during this time. Now the antar dasha was of sun. So see, sun is the Arkesh planet here, and it is gone to the 8th house. So whenever the Markesh forms a connection with the 8th house, it becomes a very deathly yoga. So the probability of life goes during. So it is a very bad condition which is being shown by the Antardasha Lord Sun here, because it has literally gone to the 8th house and connected with the 8th Lord here. Now we will see the Pratyantar Dasha, which is of Ketu. Now Ketu is again in the ascendant, and it is going to give the results of the dispositor, and the dispositor is Saturn. Again the same thing, 12th Lord and sitting in the 4th house and getting the results of 3rd house. So 3rd house is what? 3rd house is about communication. So he was doing some acting, some fighting scene when he got hurt. From here, Saturn is also aspecting his 6th house of disease or difficulty. So Saturn is going to play the role of 4th house presence and 3rd house presence here. So the Antardasha was not showing good results. So let's go to the Navamsha chart and see what actually happened. So here Saturn has one sign of Gemini here, and it's gone to the 9th house. So any planet which goes to the 9th house or the quadrant house or to its friend sign will always give you very good results. Okay, so here Saturn has gone to its friend sign and it has gone to the to the 9th house. So Saturn is well placed here. Now let's look at Sun. So Sun, from the 8th house, it has gone to the 11th house here. 11th house is the house of recovery also. It is a good house and it is sitting in its own Amsha. So Sun is very, very powerful here. So Sun is not that bad as it is looking here in the D1 chart. So it is sitting in a house of recovery and the own in the own Amsha. So, and Ketu is again sitting in the 4th house. Any planet sitting in the Kendra of the Navamsha chart is again a good position. It will gain 60% of strength. And Ketu is sitting in its friend sign. Ketu considers Saturn as its friend. So Ketu is also giving good results. Now if you want to get more clarity to this, you can do the Rashi Tulya Navamsha here. So what we do is, we can just superimpose this Saturn to this chart. So Saturn gone to the Gemini sign will be placed here. Okay, so any planet which is placed in the 5th house always gives us recovery, because 6th house is the house of difficulties and disease, and when a planet is placed in the 5th house, it will give us recovery. So Saturn is giving him recovery here. And Sun, as I told you, it has gone to the Leo sign. So here we superimpose it. It has gone to its own sign, so which is actually it is getting disconnected with the 8th house. If it had still had the connection with the 8th house, in that case the things would have been bad. But the good thing is that it disconnected from the 8th house and it went back to its own sign. So this condition is also a Markesh condition, but he was saved. The reason being is because it is disconnecting with the 8th Lord, that is Mercury. But if we see here, Mercury is again with the Leo sign. So Mercury will also play its role somehow. So, but it was not active. So what we can interpret is that after that incident, he remained in hospital for a couple of days. But after that, he is still very careful about his digestion, about his health. And till date, he has not fully recovered, because the Navamsha Mercury is still sitting here in the 7th house with Sun. So he still has some issues related to that incident that happened so many years ago. So
right.
He has
right.
So now I'll give you another example. Can you see the screen? Are you able to see the screen?
No, I am not able to see the screen.
So see, now this example is of education of a child who did face some troubles related to her education. She did not have much interest in education. So see, we will see this chart. The ascendant is having debilitated Jupiter, which is retrograde. So it is showing cancellation. See, for the studies part, we will always give importance to the fifth house. Because if the fifth house is strong, it will show great abilities to acquire education. Okay. And it is the house of our intellect. Next importance we'll give to the planet Mercury, which is about grasping things, which is about intelligence. And third importance we will give to Jupiter, which is a significator of knowledge of education. So three things have to be given importance here. Now let's look at this chart. So see, Jupiter, as I told you, it is getting cancellation. Now looking at the fifth house, the fifth lord has gone to the sixth house. This shows that the person is lacking interest in education. The person is not looking that intelligent as per this chart. Now the sixth lord has also gone to the fifth house. So this exchange is not considered good. So it shows lack of interest in studies. Now looking at Mercury, which is getting the aspect of Saturn, again it slows down the understanding level of the child. Okay, but if you only did the readings through this chart, you would have said that the person will not do much studies, he is not much interested in studies. Okay, and the aspect of Jupiter is not very beneficial here, because Jupiter is the third lord and the 12th lord, so this aspect is not even going to do much. But the thing is that the child is doing post graduation in psychology and doing wonderfully well in her studies, and the reason for this lies in the Navamsha chart. So now let's look at the Navamsha. So the fifth lord, that is Venus, has gone to the ninth house, which is a powerful house we just discussed, and Venus is sitting in its own sign. This is again a powerful condition, and Venus is also sitting with exalted moon. So the fifth house will recover. As per the Navamsha chart, it will show recovery. Now we will look at the condition of Mercury. Mercury, which is the Karaka for intelligence, has gone to its exaltation sign here.
Right.
So, and also in the first
Digvali. Class, and also Digvali.
The person. Yes. So the person is extremely intelligent. Okay. So Mercury is also showing good results. And then we will look at the condition of Jupiter, which is a Karaka for intelligence. Sorry, right. Karaka for knowledge.
Knowledge.
And Jupiter is sitting in the magnific Amsha. Jupiter sitting in the Amsha of Mercury, or Mercury sitting in the Amsha of Jupiter, is considered as very good. And Jupiter sitting in the ascendant, again very
good. Again Digvali.
For this person's.
Again Jupiter is Digvali.
It is very good for acquiring. Although it is not good for the marriage part, but it is good for acquiring knowledge. So this is how the person improved in her abilities to acquire knowledge. And now this person wants to do doctorate also. Sudden interest in studies has developed. And this example is, I think, worthy of sharing. Now let's look at the third example.
Okay.
Able to see the screen?
Okay. We can see the screen.
This is the third example for marriage part. See, in this chart, if you see the seventh house, see, for any kind of prediction, we have to give importance to three things. First is to the house, second is to the house lord, third is to the Karaka. What can you say about the person's marriage here? The seventh house is not in good dignity. Reason being, it is afflicted by Mars. Okay. And it is having the affliction by planet Mercury, which is there. Okay. So in this case, any person would say this person is not having a cordial marriage life.
Correct.
And Venus is first. It with the Karka for marriage, and this is a male's chart. So Venus is also combust here. You can say that the happiness, the Karkas will always give you the happiness. You can see that the happiness is also not sufficient here for this person. So all the things looks like in problem here in this chart. Now, if we look at the Navamsha, we will get the answer. So now let's look at the condition of Sun. Sun has gone to the Amsha of Venus, which is the Amsha of a benefic planet. Although it is its enemy sign, but it is still an Amsha of a benefic planet. So things can be irritating, but things are good. Now Sun is sitting in the second house. So any planet which is sitting in the second house of the Navamsha is considered as a neutral placement. It depends upon the second lord. Now the second lord here is placed very well in its own sign. So it is strengthening planet Sun here. Okay. Now let's look at the condition of Venus, which is the significator of marriage. It is again in the second house in its own sign. So the person is having gains coming through his marriage. Okay. So this is how we can connect the Rashi chart with the Navamsha chart. Now we will do the Rashi Tulya Navamsha thing also on this chart. So we will place Sun and Venus to the second sign here in the main chart. When we superimposed Sun and Venus here, the story reversed completely. Now let's see how. Whenever the 10th Lord goes to the 4th house, it will give you excellent results through your spouse. Because 4th house is the house of comforts, it is the house of happiness. So the person will get lots of comforts through his spouse. Okay. Now, Venus has also gone to the 4th house, and Venus is the Karka of the 4th house, secondary Karka of the 4th house. So, and also it is sitting in its own sign. So again, Venus is going to give him lots of happiness coming through his spouse. Okay. So this is how we can understand this chart through the Rashi Tulya Navamsha. And planet Saturn is sitting here, which is the ascendant lord. Okay. So we can see that Saturn is also afflicting Venus and Sun here by its presence. So the person did undergo some initial difficulties in his married life, but later on the things improved drastically. Because see, Saturn has gone to the debilitation sign here in the Navamsha, and if we superimpose it, Saturn will go to the 3rd house. So the presence of Saturn on superimposition will move back to the 3rd house. So Venus and Sun will be going to the 4th house, which is a good placement for happiness of marriage. Although Venus is combust here, but still he is able to get good results, because the effects of combustion will eventually go down with time. The Correct. Person is unborn, so the areas of combustion will mellow down with time. After 35, they will go down. So the person is having a good married life. And simultaneously, one can also study the Navamsha chart separately for marriage. That is another part. But today, our topic is to connect the main chart with the Navamsha chart. We have to always use the Rashi Tulya Navamsha as well as the sign placement of planets and understand the results. Any planet going to the quadrants or to the trines will always give you good results, and any planet going to their own sign, Mutrikon sign, or going to their exaltation sign will also give you good results. In their friend sign, they will give you moderate results. And in the enemy signs, they can give you difficulties. And any planet going to 6, 8, 12 of the Navamsha chart will give you obstacles or struggles. But if they are in their exaltation, in that case, you will be able to overcome those struggles. So you have to give equal importance to the house placement in the Navamsha chart as well as to the sign placement. So you can say to the sign placement, you can give 60% importance, and to the house placement, you can give 40% importance. Both the things have to go simultaneously. And for more clarity, you can just do the superimposition by doing the Rashi Tulya Navamsha, and you can understand the things well.
Correct. So this was wonderful analysis on the three chart. And today, Monisha ji has given us a lot of wonderful techniques of C.S. Patel also, and the prediction of Navamsha and D1 and how to read that. So viewers, I guess if you are having any comment or any problem, if you are not able to understand or anything like that, do write us below in the comment section. So definitely me and Monisha Bhatia ji can definitely give you some answers to that, to the questions. So Monisha ji, very, very thank you to visit my channel Om Astro Jyoti. So I will definitely look out for more videos that the independent reading of the Navamsha that we will do very soon. Thank you.